day 8 of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 7. The last final cruise of the week back to the boatyard. And it's another sad smiley face. Yes, the Admiral mug is all packed away and we're all set and organised. And I've got to say, I make no apologies about my attire because, quite frankly, it's bloody cold. Very cold. There is no wind this morning, but my God, it was a cold night. Very, very bitterly cold. So, vamped up very, very warm this morning, getting some nice heat in me. But yes, it's the final cruise, and it looks like it's going to be a bit dull, very cold, but very still and peaceful cruise back to the boatyard, very, very shortly. And it's been a very relaxing, chilling week indeed. Not really much has been happening. I've eaten probably a wee bit too much, but not as much as I usually eat. I've drank possibly a little bit too much, but not as much as I usually drink. So it's definitely been one for calm, de-stress, relaxation, and just sort of unwinding, you know, and enjoying the tranquility to its fullest, you know. So yeah, it's actually been very, very good indeed. I thoroughly enjoyed it, you know. And perhaps the weather hasn't been the best, but it's not been too bad, you know. It's only rained a couple times, and it's not been full on, so. But it's April, you know. When you come off season, I mean, even when you go in season, you're not guaranteed for the weather, but it's usually a bit warmer and at least a bit milder. You know, when you come off season, you know, you take your chance, you know, and either way, it's definitely going to be a wee bit chillier. But I mean, last year when I came in April, you know, it was I was sitting outside in Horning having an ice cream cone with Tiberius, you know, in March. A couple of years ago, you know, I got sunburnt, you know, so, yeah, it's just the way the weather goes in this country, you know, just never quite sure. Sometimes you're lucky, sometimes you're not. But it doesn't really matter, because, you know, the tranquility and the peace and the wonder of the Broads remains the same, you know. So, yeah. I'm not going to babble too much. I'm still a bit too cold. I've not had enough coffee and I'm needing to wake up a bit and heat up a bit. Nothing much to update you with except I'm just going back to the boatyard. I don't want to go back to the boatyard. But we'll take a wee sort of a musical journey back to the boatyard up the river. And no doubt I'll maybe say a few words back there as well. As always though, I'll keep you updated if anything does occur. So until later, I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now. Cheers. Okay, I think it's time for the Admiral's walkthrough of Fair Executive Number 2 from Norfolk Broads Direct. This is one of their premier class vessels. And I must say, it's one of the most luxurious, comfortable boats I have actually ever been on. You do pay for it, but I have thoroughly enjoyed my time. I've been very comfortable and definitely worth the money if you can afford her. She's a sedan style cruiser, so she's got this lovely wee sort of well deck out the back here. She's 35 foot long, 12 foot wide. She has an air draft though of 8 feet 10. That is actually quite tall. It has prevented me from getting under Ludden Bridge. I couldn't quite make it, and because I didn't have anybody to take a sight line along the top of the boat. Yes, I wasn't going to actually chance. She will go under London Bridge. I know that for a fact. I have seen Fair Executive and its sister boat, Fair Jubilee, both on the river and under London Bridge. So she will go, but because of this height of her, she is very, very dependent on tide and luck. You can only go under there under low tide. This is the Executive. Norfolk Broads Direct also do the Fair Jubilee. Both are identical in every way except the Fair Executive comes with a sofa bed, and I will talk about that a little bit later. You can probably see, I don't know if you just see on the front there, but just zoom in, there is a wee dome situated on the front of the Fair Executive. And a lot of Norfolk Broads Directs have these boats, that is satellite TV. So basically you switch the TV on, you push a button that whirls around, finds a signal and gives you a good satellite TV. For the most part it works very, very well. I've had a strong, stable signal, and only once has it been a wee bit sort of had a wee hiccup to itself with the signal, but it's soon stabilised. Stepping on board is actually very, very easy. The free boards here, although quite wide, it's quite a tall boat here from the free boards, so if you're moored up, there can be quite a big heavy step to get down to and from. But as you can see, there's grab rails at the front, all the way along the top of the boat and down the side and around the back. Although it's quite high, you do have these wee steps here. You've got a nice wee bailing platform. Well, I'd hardly call it a bailing platform, but it's definitely a lower step, and also a wee sort of a instep here where you can step on. I've actually been stepping onto this and through here to get on and off the boat. Far, far easier than trying to step on and off the high freeboard there. There is a 24 shore power point there. You do have a cable for shore power. I've not used it. I've never really come across any opportunity to use shore power on this particular one, but it is nice that Norfolk Broads Direct do actually give you shore power cables to connect up. One thing I do like about this boat, you can't really see it in this light I'm afraid, is but you do get plenty of LEDs out the back here. They're very, very welcoming. Just let me step on here. You've got another three LEDs there, you've got another one there, two there, and another one there. It means that at night, when you come back to the boat, you switch them on, you know, and the whole back end of the boat is lit up. And this back area here is very, very comfortable and quite wide indeed. The seats are quite firm but soft, in that, you know, you don't actually get comfortable. One of the best days I had, I think it was Tuesday, I literally sat here on Womack Island drinking wine, just watching the world go by, and I was out here for hours and I never once got sort of numb bum or anything like that. So very comfortable, and a nice wee wide deck. It's going to be a wee bit messy because I've just been standing off there and it's very damp and wet, so my poplins are going to be everywhere. One wee thing that I quite like is you get these wee steps here. I did mention about the high freeboard. Well, if you wanted to come on and off the side of the boat, or if you had to go walk down and back, maybe for the mud weight like I've done a couple of times, or to pick up and put back your rope, there's a nice wee side step here to assist you when you come down here. And obviously you've got another side step there. Your water point is here. Quite good location for it, actually. I've never really had too much of an issue with that at all. Obviously pump out and diesel. I think that's the pump out one and diesel's on the other side, but that, you don't need to worry about that. On the floor deck of the well, you've got your gas locker. You never really need to worry about that at all. You get plenty of gas and it's an automatic transfer between the two bottles. One good wee feature that you've obviously noticed about the Fair Executive, and I have loved on this adventure, is these huge, massive French windows. you know. You sit there inside looking out, you know, and it's such a wonderful view. It really opens up the whole boat, you know, and it's even if it's, well, like I say, I mean, Tuesday was only about the day I really sat outside. The rest of the time it's been a bit cold, wet, you know, whatever. So it's been great to be able to sit in there and literally have a window to the world out the back of the boat. Fantastic windows, and very easy to open. They come on rungers. They're three-part windows, so you just literally just slide it open like that, and it slides and slides open. Very, very good, you know. So loving these windows. Also means that access in and out of the boat is very, very easy. Just slide on in. Let me just slide these doors back shut again. And this is the saloon, and what a wonderful, comfortable saloon it is. It really, really is. Once I said, the Fair Executive and Fair Jubilee are absolutely identical in boats, except the Fair Executive comes with a sofa bed. Now, funnily enough, I have actually been sleeping on this sofa bed on this adventure. And it is actually rather comfortable indeed. Excuse all the bedding, I've not quite put it away yet. So it's a comfortable couch to sit on when watching the satellite TV, which is here. But also, you just pull the cushions out, pull the bed out, it all lays out, and it's also a very comfortable bed. Nice soft mattress, but not too thin. So you're feeling the springs of the actual bed, but not too thick either, you know, just actually very, very comfortable. I've enjoyed sleeping in that if it hadn't been for the cold this week. You also get a wee, the obligatory pull-out table, and these curtains are actually very, very nice, you know. Not really picking them up, but the lovely colour, quite thick material, you know, very good at blocking out the light. So yes, these curtains have been actually quite nice, and as you see, you get the plenty curtains as well. You also get curtains up here for the sunroof. It's not really a sunroof as such, but you can sort of flip these off if it gets a wee bit too hot allow ventilation in, but it also allows a lot of light to come in, and it's very, very nice indeed. You know, you get these chairs as well. Once again, they're very, very nice. Let me just turn this heating off a wee bit. They're quite comfortable. I've sat on them once or twice. You know, I suspect that the reason you get these two chairs here, when primarily it's just a two-person boat, is You put them out there, you know. If there was four of you, and it is classed as a four berth cruiser, you know, you could two people could sit on either side, you know, another couple either side there, or pull out your table, have a nice wee al fresco dining area out the back, or maybe if you were didn't want to eat on the couch, you know, you can pull the table out and sit on the seats, you know. One thing I do like about this, you know, you've got some good wine storage on here, and then if you pull this forward here, you've also got some wine storage there. You can probably still see some wine bottles sitting there. Not yet. Tons of storage on this boat, though. Absolutely tons of storage on this boat. You know, you've got big cupboards there, drawers there, you know, and they're deep and quite far back, you know. So, loving the storage on this boat. Obviously the obligatory DVD combi unit, TV, satellite, that was one thing that threw me, is that it's got a satellite dish, but it hooks into a satellite receiver, which is in there, you know. This odd thing is that the only issue I kind of had with that setup is that if you wanted to watch the satellite TV and have the ability to change the channel, you had to sit with this door open in order for to use the remote control, but that's just a wee minor niggle, you know. I love these wee sort of granite effect worktops up here, you know, and obviously a wee fruit bowl, you know. So yeah, one wee thing you get, once again, it's massive storage space. You've got a huge deep cupboard in here, you know, and it's like, wow, you know. I never really used that, you know, but it is actually hanging space. It's a bit of a small wardrobe. So once again, if anybody is sleeping here, you've actually got a bit of a wardrobe to hang your shirts or your jumpers or your trousers. So it's actually a lot of thought has gone into this boat. Very, very good. I don't know if you can see it, but there is, this confused me for a wee while. It's a part of a chair, you know, or it looks like a wee sort of a three-quarter chair. And it confused me because I wondered, well, what is that? What is that for? You know, why would you have a bit of a chair? You've got plenty of chairs here and a nice comfortable couch. I couldn't figure it out. Then I did, and this is what it says. This is a neat wee trick. Helm seat, you know, once again, very, very comfortable, you know, good support on the legs, nice seating space for your bum, nice backrest, very, very comfortable. But what if there's two of you? I mean, if there's two of you, somebody has to sit down there, you know. The view out is, obviously, they get a lovely view out the back, but maybe not so good a view out the front. But if I pull that, you know, the seat extends out, and that's where your other wee chair bit goes. You put your chair wee bit in there, and all of a sudden a three-quarter chair turns into a two-person chair, and two of you can sit there and watch as you cruise down the river. Fantastic, lovely wee feature. That I thought that was brilliant, you know, and not very often see something like that. That tries to take into consideration two people view out the front. So I really, really, really like that, you know. You've obviously got LEDs all the way through the interior, you know. Lovely, lovely soft lighting. Very, illuminates the boat very, very well. You've also got two speakers here for the radio. Actually, quite good speakers. Really enjoyed that. I do have a wee sort of a wee box that, you know, one of these USB wireless speaker boxes. I bought them a wee while ago because I felt on some of these boats, you know, it was better quality than the speakers they install in here, but not on this boat. I have loved listening to these speakers. Right, proper speakers. So moving to the helm position, we obviously got a 240 volt, which is plugged in at the moment with my phone. The obligatory stereo radio CD cassette with auxiliary socket to plug into your iPhone. Your 240 volt inverter, and of course a temperature adjusting heater stroke cooling for winter or not so winter weather. Up here on the helm, obviously your throttle, you've got your bilge pump, your water pump, your wiper, which actually controls two wipers, one in front of you and one in the middle. And that button there is for the satellite. So you would switch that, you would heat up, burl around and track in, and yeah. Obviously down below here you've got your horn, your volts, your temperatures, your domestic volts, your RPM gauge. This here is it's your GPS. It shows your GPS speed. It shows the mileage you've done since you fired up the engine, so that resets every time. And it took a wee while to figure out what was out here. I don't know if it'll actually go on. No, it'll not go on until I fired up the engine. There's another wee reading here, but I eventually sussed that out as you're basically a compass heading. So that was actually
quite a nice wee display there. And obviously, warning lights. The only thing I would probably say, the steering wheel itself is very, very lovely, very comfortable, nice and thick, you know, and easy to move. But it's maybe just a little bit low down. It's difficult to see this gauge here. You can probably see that, you know, if you're sitting properly up, you know, it's, yeah, you kind of have to squint down and back to see the gauge. But it is actually... It would be nice if it just angled just slightly up, or just up a wee tad. But that's just an incidental niggle, and it's not really been an issue at all. Down here is your bow thrusters, left and right. Not bad bow thrusters, actually, although I'm assuming they are hydraulically powered, because they work better when you've got a wee bit of revs on. I don't know too much about mechanics or engineering, but yeah, I'm assuming they are hydraulically powered. And obviously, down here to the left is the obligatory trip switch. Nice wee sort of artistic painting there. The view out the front is, it's not too bad actually, you know? I mean, I've not really done sedan cruisers before, so... The view's not too bad. You can't see much just now because they're all steamed up. But one thing I have to say about this boat is the sheer amount of glass and visibility really is impressive at all. Impressive indeed. It is very light, very airy, very bright. And the only issue I sort of had is that if I was coming into a mooring or passing a boat on this side over here, it was difficult to see where that corner is on the starboard bow side. It's a major blind spot, and obviously down by the freeboard you just can't see anything at all. But actually just cruising down the river trying to moor up, mooring up was obviously going to be a wee bit difficult on that side, but stern moorings are so easy with those French windows. Absolutely nail a stern mooring every single time. And out the port side is, yeah, you can see that. You've obviously got windows here as well. So, yeah, it's very, very easy on the port side. Love the glass and the visibility on this. There is obviously... as well, just while I'm remembering this, another wee sort of window here, if you wanted to, for ventilation, if you wanted to open that out, you know. And which brings us down into the galley. A couple of steps. Once again, more storage space, you know, under there, that's where your bin is. Couldn't find a dustpan, which was a bit strange, you know, but I'd actually discovered that it's actually a very deep cupboard indeed, and your dustpan and bucket is away at the back there. So once again, excellent storage space, you know. Pretty much a full size fridge there, more cupboards, drawers with the old cutlery and pots and pans, and more cupboards there. Your typical cooker, I'll just show you this. If you try and pull that, it doesn't work, you know. Why doesn't it? There's a wee catch there. You pull and I can't do it one hand, but basically you pull that and you flip it open. There you go. See, that's how you, that's just a wee catch. So if you come across that, that's how you open the oven. It's a three burner hob, you know, which is has actually served us very, very well. And the good thing about this motor here is that you get a wee glass cover just to pop it down, so it actually looks very, very nice on the granite effect top. You do get the microwave, and obviously the cooking facilities. You get a wee percolator. Is that a percolator? It's one of these plungy things. Why do you get a wee plungy thing? Because when you one of the part of the welcome pack is proper coffee, proper coffee. So that's why you get given one of these. Very, very nice. You also get a wee toaster. It's just a wee basic thing. You need to spin the bread round halfway through, but wee toaster, bread bin. And it's actually quite a large workspace here, you know. Wee vent. Once these wee windows, although quite narrow, do permit some good light
and to filter into the cabin. And because you're down here, because it's all open, you are benefited, even in the galley, from all these massive windows here. So it's very, very light and very, very spacious, you know. And of course, you can still talk to anybody that's either helming or sitting enjoying the view. Lovely, lovely, comfortable galley here, you know. Nice wee clock, and obviously, yeah. In here, more LED lights here. In here, what we have is this is your shower, you know, quite a wee basic thing, you know. It's actually bigger than it looks, you know. And it's very, very, it's a good shower, actually. You know, good pressure, good temperature, you know. I'm 5'10", I had to stoop slightly, you know, to get in there. But it's not bad at all, not bad at all. Size-wise, you know, I mean, height, you know, you'll always suffer compromising in a lot of these boats. But as size and width-wise, it's a good, good, large shower. Like I say, I had to stoop slightly at 5'10", so if you're taller than 5'10", 6 feet, you might need to stoop quite a bit to get under there. But very, very, very lovely. So, yeah. Okay, so that's the shower there. Very, very good shower. Very, very roomy. Just like I say, if you're over 6'10", let me start again. I've not had enough coffee this morning. If you're over 5'10", you might have to do a wee bit of stooping, but the actual shower itself is very big. On this side of the you have a wash basin, you have your toilet with electric flush, just like you get in the domestic, and it's very good just to come in and use that just as normal and don't think about pumping handles or anything like that. But over here, you have a jacuzzi bath, and I've got to say, this is a large one. Unlike the one in Swan Radiance, where it was more like a half bath, where I just sort of squatted in it, this looks like you could probably fit two people in it very, very comfortably. I must admit, I haven't used this. I just never quite got around to it, which, considering how cold it's been the last few days, you know, you'd think it would be lovely to actually use one of them, but no. Lovely, lovely feature though. Looks amazing, and I'm quite sure it would be very comfortable indeed. Lovely sort of mirror there, frosted windows, a wee sort of hatch there as well, and of course LED lights. Got a wee towel rail, wee thing for your toothbrush, shaver sockets, lights, and obviously another mirror there in front of the sink, you know. And I like this how they've put this granite effect just running around the edge of the bath there as well. Very, very nice. It's actually a very, I would imagine if you were sitting in here one evening enjoying a little sort of a bubbly's whirlpool effect in the bath, I suspect this would be a very, very nice place to be indeed. So that's your toilet, and then through these doors at the back is your cabin. Now obviously it's in a bow, and what a lovely, lovely place this is indeed. You've got obligatory LEDs at the top. You've also got a couple of LED reading lights there, a nice wee cover there for light. There is a cover on the outside you can pull over to like a curtain. You've also got a couple of side windows with vents on either side with curtains, and of course a TV / DVD combi player. Nice wee mirror there, and once again, storage, lots and lots of storage in here, you know, and all these sort of shelves with a granite effect, you know, all the way along here. I mean, that's my big case and it still takes it, you know. You've got shelves there, a wee step there, you know, shelves, steps, cupboards, another full-size wardrobe, you know, for hanging space, a couple of blankets, your brushes in there. You've also got a 240 volt socket in here as well, you know. And the bed, well, you know, I've not actually used this bed, But I have been told it's very, very comfortable. There is only one niggle, one major niggle that I have been told about this boat that I have discovered myself, and that the bed, although wide, although very comfortable, has a step behind the pillows. Just this step here. Okay, it's not a major step, it's only about like half an inch, an inch, okay, but it means that you tend to sit, lie down a wee bit further, and even a short person will end up with their feet hanging off the bottom of it. It's actually a short bed because of that step. Move up to the actual headboard and it's not a problem for most people, I have been told it's quite a short bed, and that might be a bit of an irritant for tall or normal sized people actually. But so that's really, I mean, that's just a niggle, you know, but it's something worth pointing out. Other than that, you know, gorgeous, lovely bed to and very comfortable to spend the night in. There is also a heating vent in here, as you can probably hear the whirling away. And that concludes the Admiral's walkthrough of Fair Executive number 2. For the most part, Executive and Jubilee absolutely identical. There might be a wee change in the furnishings, you know, and the colour scheme, but both boats are identically laid out to this. You know, same features, same layout, and the only difference between Executive and Jubilee is that the Executive has the sofa bed in the saloon, the Jubilee does not. So the Jubilee is a strict two-person, one-cabin boat. The Executive is a, they call it a four-person boat. I'm not sure I would want to put four people on this boat, but as a young family, you know, mum, dad, and maybe a one child, you know, that would work very well on this boat, you know. But yeah, she has been absolutely flawless, very comfortable, very warm, absolutely handles like a dream. She is very tall, so it has prevented us from going some places we I would otherwise go to. But yeah, she has been worth every penny. And when I say that, she is not cheap. She is definitely a premium class, but she's got a premium feel about her. The only place you will find on this boat the sort of that white gel coat moulding of the boat is around the helm position. Everything else is covered in this sort of soft head lining, you know, or granite effect, or these sort of carpeted walls, you know. No exposed gel coat at all, and it really does make such a difference to the feel and the warmth of the boat, you know. She really does, she feels that she wouldn't be too out of place, you know, sitting in a marina or off the coast of a Mediterranean, you know, island somewhere. You know, she's just got that feel. Very, very comfortable and well worth every penny of her. And that concludes the Admiral's walkthrough. You know, I hope you've enjoyed it. I've loved my time on board. It's just a shame I have to take her back now, you know. But, So that's the Admiral's walkthrough, and I will hope you've enjoyed the walkthrough. And if you are thinking about Executive or Jubilee from Norfolk Broads Direct, I would highly, highly, highly recommend it. You know, you will not be disappointed in any way, especially if you happen to have good weather where you can sit out the back there and enjoy the view. Definitely. So. That concludes the Admiral's walkthrough. Thanks for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye!
You were in my dreams, always in my dreams. That was long before I ever saw you standing there. When I felt afraid of the choice I made, I would close my eyes and hope my dreams would comfort me. But now I'm free. Who needs to dream when there is you? Who needs a heaven to look forward to? For my long as you were there, then I believed in me. Now suddenly, who needs to dream when there is you? Who needs a heaven to look forward to? For my whole dream come true. Now you are my dream, you are my only dream. I'll hold you in my heart forever. Who needs to dream?
Who needs a heaven for? so amore che io e te forse stiamo insieme solo qualche istante. Zitti stiamo ad ascoltare il cielo alla finestra, questo mondo che si sveglia e la notte è già così lontana, già lontana. Guarda questa terra che gira insieme a noi, anche quando è buio. Guarda questa terra che gira anche per noi, a darci un po' di sole, sole, sole. My love, che sei l'amore mio, sento la tua voce e ascolto il mare. Sembra davvero il tuo respiro, l'amore che mi dai, questo amore che sta lì nascosto in mezzo alle sue onde, a tutte le sue onde, come una barca che guarda questa terra che gira insieme a noi, anche quando è buio. Guarda questa terra che gira anche per noi.
Thank you.
Okay, just a little wee update for you. That is me back at the boatyard. Very, very sedate, lovely, beautiful wee cruise back up the river. There is no wind. The sun was trying to come out this morning, and the river was flat calm, and it was just such a serene, tranquil little cruise up. Came straight down into the boatyard and plonked right down at the bottom, and very nicely spotted in as well. Here slightly too early, but it's just as well because it looks like a number of people have had the same idea as me, and that's get here very, very early and very sharp. And so yeah, that's it. That is now officially the end of the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure 7. It's been very relaxing, very chilling sort of week this week. Very unlike what previous adventures have been, but it's been very good actually. Just taking the time out and just, you know, just unwinding, if you like, you know. But yes, although this is the end of adventure number 7, there is, would you believe it, 3 more coming this year. I am back on in June. I'm back at Barnes Brinkcraft on Royal Stuart. I'm back at Norfolk Broads Direct in July aboard Fair Majesty. That's going to be an interesting adventure. I will you'll find out about that in July. And I'm back again at Barnes Brinkcraft in September on Royal Commander. So, 4 adventures this year is going to be pretty awesome. And if this one has been a bit quiet, I'm quite sure the rest of them will be the usual hilarity and mischievous drunken sort of, that you kind of expect. So, yes. So in the meantime, I'm not going to babble too much. I'm trying to limit the rambling, so I'll go for now. If you have been watching this adventure, I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you've not been too bored with it. And please, come again, join me in June when we are once again back on the rivers for another week on the Norfolk Broads in the Great Norfolk Broads Adventure number 8. So until then, thanks for watching. Bye for now. Cheers!